Dear readers and paper writers, today we discussing very important topic, how to prepare article for a particular journal. Today we talking about the preparation of an article for the Indian Journal of Economics and Development, published by the Society of Economics and Development, Ludhiana. So if we look at the components of article, nearly all general articles are divided into major sections like title, author, abstract, introduction, methodology, result and discussion, conclusion and references. So these are the major components which are have been used by one or all, generally all the journals. So looking at the component of articles which is used by the Indian Journal of Economics and Development, first one is title. So give the title, then name of the authors, affiliation of the authors, email of the corresponding author, abstract of 100 words, it may be 125 words, keywords 3 to 4 and JEL codes 3 to 4. JEL code you can download from the website, it's available on the website www.soed.in. you can download and sign 3 to 4 keywords. So next is the introduction, about 700 to 1000 words. Methodology you can give as much as you want, the description of methodology, it's not limited to pages. Then result and discussion, then references, then notes if any, acknowledgement if we want to give, funding sources if any, and certificate of competing interest. So these are the 15 components which are generally used by the Indian Journal of Economics and Development for a particular paper. So first of all we talk about title. The title of the article should be crisp and catchy. It should reflect the content or the subject matter of the article. Keep the title as short as possible. It should not be so technical that only specialist will understand. The title should be appropriate for the intended audience. And along with this, you can also suggest the short title of your paper. So the title of the paper should be catchy and crisp. It should reflect the subject matter of your article, what you want to convey to the audience, that should reflect in the title. Then come the authors. The scientist who led the work should be listed as the first author in the research paper. The names of other scientists or authors should be given in order of as per their contribution. Put superscript starting with number one on the first author and so on. Do not include the name of the scientist who has not significant work for the preparation of a article. Only include the names of scientists who actually contributed in the preparation of the article. Then come the affiliation of authors. The affiliation and designation of all other scientists should be listed as per sequence of their names. Add the superscript at the designation starting with number one and so on. Add the email of the corresponding author and put a star on the name of the corresponding author so one can distinguish that who is the corresponding author. Put the star on the name of the author and then put star used for the corresponding author. We look at the example later on. So this is the example. The title of article is Impact of COVID-19 on the Economy of China. The authors are Hashmat Ullah Khan, Rukaiya Cheng Yiling. So we added number one here, two here and three. Then we first and third author came from the same department, so we combined them two into single. Then Rukaiya is the corresponding author, we put the star here and also shown in the corresponding author email also. So this is the method how to write the title, author and affiliation of the authors. Now we come to abstract. abstract is a short summary of about 100 to 125 words or the important points of the paper. Friends, it does not generally include background information. There may be very brief statement of the rationale for conducting the study. It describes what was done but without details. So there is no need to give the details. It also describes the results in a summarized way, generally includes whether or not the statistical tests were significant. It usually conclude with a brief statement of the importance of results. Abstract do not include the reference. References should not be included in the abstract. That should be kept in mind. While writing a paper, the abstract is always the last part to be written. The purpose of the abstract is to allow potential reader of a paper to find out the important points of the paper without having to actually read the paper. Gentlemen, it should be a self-contained unit capable of being understood without the benefit of the text of the article. It essentially serves as an advertisement of the paper that reader use to determine whether or not they actually want to wade through the entire paper or not. So it should include about 100 to 125 words to summarize the purpose, method, result and conclusion of the paper along with the policy option. It should be self-contained unit and it should be which one can understand without reading the whole article. At the end of the abstract, you can add keywords 3 to 4. The keywords should not come from the title of the paper. That should be avoided. Yale code, you can use 2 to 4 Yale code and you can download from the website of the society. Then come the, this is the example of the abstract. So this is how we write the abstract. We write the 125 words, then we use the keyword Yale code. So abstract, the keywords you have to arrange them alphabetically. Similarly, Yale code also alphabetically with their numbers. Now come the introduction. Introduction provide the background information necessary to understand why the described study was conducted. Introduction should describe previous research on the topic that has led to unanswered question being answered or addressed by the present study and should cite important previous papers that form the background for the study. A good introduction should be fairly heavy with citations. This indicates the reader that the authors are informed about the previous work on the topic and not working in a vacuum. Citation also provide jumping point to allow the reader to explore other tangents to the subject that are not directly addressed in this paper. So in the paper, if the paper support or fuel the previous work, reader can look up the citation and make the comparison for themselves. So you should be specific on the topic of the paper, introduce the background, define key terms and concept. It should address three questions: what, why and how. After finishing the introduction, the reader should know what paper is about, why it was worth reading and how you will build your argument. So introduction summarize the relevant literature so that the reader will understand why you are interested in the question you ask. It should be supported with the existing literature. At the end, in introduction, enumerate the objective of the search article. So this is how we to write the introduction. Give the build in such a way so that it can reflect the whole gamut of your research, what you are going to do and what are the gaps in the gaps remain in the research, that your research will fill the gaps. That is important how to write the introduction. Then come the methodology. The function of this section is to describe all procedures, methods, give complete information so that if someone else want to conduct a search can repeat someone else to repeat your work. If someone else want to conduct a search on similar topic, he is able to follow your methodology, can conduct a search on some other topic. So it explains why each procedure was used, was done, what variable were you are measuring and why. Mathematical equations and statistical tests are considered should be described in section. If any of your method is fully described in previous publication, you can cite that instead of describing the procedure again, meaning thereby that avoid the already known methods. Only you can refer their names. Sometimes people give how to work out the growth rate. They try to explain each and everything, how the equation look like, how to work out, how the everything is to work out by working the growth rate. That is not required. Just mention the name that you have, which model you have used. If you have used the exponential method, just write exponential method or model was used to estimate the growth rates. So this is how we to write the methodology. Methodology describes how the research was conducted with the detail about the study sample, assessment measures and procedure. Then you have to give the selection of study area, selection of the sample, sample size, statistical techniques used in data analysis, the software used in the data analysis. All these things should be described in detail. So you can give every detail, but the known statistical tools should be avoided, that should not be given. Just cite them, they'll give their reference only. Then come the result and discussion. The function of this section is to summarize general trend in the data without comment bias. The result of statistical test should apply to your data are reported in this section. Tables and figures should be used when they are a more efficient way to convey information than verbal description. They must be independent units accompanied by explanatory captions that allow them to understand by someone who has not read the text. Do not repeat in the text information the table and figures, but cite them with summary of statement when that is appropriate. End the discussion with summary of principal point you want the reader to remember. Do not close on what you wish you had done, rather finish stating your conclusion and contribution. So in result and discussion, you have to compare and contrast your result with the previous result. If you compare and if you accept or refute the findings or your finding in comparison to the already studies done, that will increase the acceptability of your article. And if you compare and contrast the finding with the later existing literature, that will definitely increase the acceptability chances of your article. So you have to, in conclusions, you have to summarize the main finding in 150 words. It should explain how the result answers the search question and may suggest policy deduced from your findings. You have to give the findings, policy options or conclusion from your findings. Do not cite the references in conclusions. I have seen that people are citing the references in conclusion. It means what are your conclusions that should be given in this section. They must also address the implication for the further search or action. If your conclusion are not powerful, it will weaken your whole article. So conclusion should be based on your findings, not of the someone else. And do not cite any reference in the conclusion. Then the reference. So listing of work cited by the authors in text of the manuscript, follow the format used by the journal in question. In present case, we use APA format. The reference should be listed alphabetically. Only cited study should be listed under the reference section. The cited and listed studies must match perfectly. I want to add here that up to 5 authors do not use at all while citing the study in a text. Rather, use all the surnames. If there are more than 5, then you can use first surname at all. So sometimes it creates so many problems, paper again sent to the author to revise it. So up to 5 authors do not use at all. If authors are more than 6, then only then use the at all with first author's surname. Now notes. If sometime you have to add to or supplement the information, via notes you can put the numeric like 1, 2, 3 as a super subscript on the last word or the material to be shown as note, and add at the end of page. Notes may also be added for the reference serial wise. If there is more information you want to add about your paper or your text, you can add added for the reference of the references with serial wise. Then acknowledgement and funding sources. Acknowledgement, if desired, it should be placed after the references. The funding sources may be given after the acknowledgement. So these are the major components of article. Appendix. This is supplement appendices you can also add, and supplementary information in some cases, additional information that is not critical to understanding the search paper, such as detail of the secondary data used in the often placed as in a appendix. Some author also add the schedule used for the data collection that can be used as put in the appendices. I hope that this information will be useful for the preparation of article published in the Indian Journal of Economics and Development, and this journal is published by the Society of Economics and Development. You may submit the competing interest certificate also while submitting the research article. I hope that you like this information and it will be useful or helpful in the preparation of search article for the Indian Journal of Economics and Development. If you like this information, kindly subscribe, like and share this video with your colleagues. Thank you for watching the video. Take care. Thank you very much.